This is J9LP, and the last time on Lunar Nights, we entered the planet eater Byron and fell foul to Polydor's traps, which had loads of really strong monsters in them. And we went to a specific trap, which had bridges that ended up from going up automatically as soon as we entered in them. We had to fight a whole bunch of orcs and piggies, but even after that, we were kind of trapped. Luckily, a group of guild gunslingers came to our rescue, led by Beer, one of the main gunslinger guild leaders, and they allowed us to carry on and enter even more of these traps. Well, that's great, isn't it? Oh, well, it doesn't matter. It's what we were paid to do, man. That's what the whole deal was. So I'm there's two of you. Or at least I need one of you to do a little bit of damage here. Nice. Straight to bird, we went stone. Garden. Hardy, ha ha ha. Okay, stick all my life back here, and I think for the rest of this place we'll use Jimmy. I'll use that as well, just create a disperse. Anyways, so one thing I've actually haven't done in this playthrough was I did touch upon it a couple of times, but one in the description and one out loud, was the main bosses in this game are actually named after famous authors of a particular genre, which would be the gothic horror and vampire genre. Come on, and the Michelle to the first. So, I did already touch on a couple of them, one of them being the Poes, who were named after Edgar and Virginia Poe. Edgar Allan Poe was a famous American author, and his cousin Virginia, who he married. He wrote a couple of gothic horror novels, namely The Black Cat, The Pit and the Pendulum, and The Fall of the House of Usher. And also, as I mentioned before, he married his cousin Virginia Clem Poe, who not long afterwards actually died of tuberculosis. And the kind of tragic thing about that is that he, let me just get prepared for this room here. Have that sweet little clear of his birth. Not long afterwards, about 2 years afterwards, in fact, he died shortly afterwards. It's a bit tragic. Kind of mirrors the tragic but kind of mushy death of the Poes in this game. So let's just get rid of these one at a time, please! Ouch! I'd rather get poisoned than confuzzled, because it's more easily dealt with. So that's the Poe. Also, Margrave Rhymer is named after James Malcolm Rhymer, who was a British author who in 1845 wrote Barney the Vampire. And he wrote those in what was back then called Penny Dreadfuls, which were essentially pamphlets that they gave out in those days, and that was later serialized in a book, which went on to be a major influence in future vampire stories. thought was interesting. With Baron Stoker, well, you can pretty much guess on who Baron Stoker is referring to. That would be one Bram Stoker, who wrote the famous novel, the gothic horror novel Dracula, which was later made into a film starring Gary Oldman. Oh, God, no. As well. And it's got this item here, which is another resurrective potion, which will fully restore health to a fallen comrade. And let me use this clairvoyance fruit, because there's a bit of a tricky hidden item here, which is this, which is a pretty cool fruit. It's an endurance fruit, which will render you impervious to damage, or potentially make you invincible for about 15 seconds. Maybe we'll use that, maybe not. And there's a whole ton of these on the terror bugs. Earth crystals around. Gee, look at them. Hardly need anything after that. Anyways, so interesting thing about Bram Stoker is that, well, for this game anyway, is that not only was he a writer, he was also involved in theatre and was personal assistant to one Henry Irving. Remember the Armed Train Irving? It may be named after that, although that name might actually be referencing a Washington Irving, who was another American author and creator of The Legend of Sleepy Hollow.
Get out of my way!
Okay, you can have them stay to this Joe, because I'm going to equip a weapon that I haven't actually been using. This one, the Yawning Gandor. I haven't been using this a lot, and I haven't really showed you how this actually works. So once we get into this bridge, I'm sure you guess what's going to happen as soon as we cross it. The bridge is going to go up, and oh crap. We kind of need those switches. Damn, looks like we're really stuck now. Darn it. Oh well, never mind. We get to tackle Skelly God with the Yawning Gander! Which is a special dark lance, which one thing I didn't actually show you, that you can actually chain your attacks up to two times now since I've carried it up. So, well, it's not my favourite weapon, it's kind of fun to use, although it doesn't do that much damage anymore, honestly. So, that on the Bram Stoker. Duke Duma. Michael, there's more. Yes, there is. Let's tackle them on. Yeah, Duke Duma is referencing an Alexandre Duma, who was actually an author, a French author, of course, of a couple of famous adventure novels, The Three Musketeers and The Count of Monte Cristo. Ouch. Darn you, Shkadigons. You sword of pure swordiness. Which, I'm equipping their machetes, so I'm not making that mistake again. I'm pretty sure that's rapiers, really. Thank you. Oh, I'm kind of torn, aren't I? Never mind. I need all this fruit here and get rid of this junk part, which is the wand. So, here's another famous author, although not necessarily linked to any vampire novels. Also, Polidori is, well, I'll explain later after. Another freaking trap? Seriously? There's more? They don't want to give up. Oh great, we're tackling these guys, really? grab that for you in my cutscene, but yep, we're tackling orcs. This is gonna go on forever! Damn you, Polidori! You and your stupid little tricks! Oh boy, we might as well. What the? Oh wow, they fell that easily? Well, we could have taken them on, didn't need you guys, but hey, well, great for you to have you around, Ernest and Kay. Looks like we're just in time. Ernest! Kay! Quite glad to see you! Well, you know, I wasn't about to let you hog all the heroics here. Huh? What are you... No! Don't touch Ernest! No, I wasn't going to cry. I wasn't going to cry rape. Seriously, that's been overdone. Anyways, we'll take care of these guys for you. You keep moving forward. But we can't just leave you! We didn't come here to die, Jimmy. We came here to do what has to be done. You got something of your own that you need to do as well, don't you? Your own battle? What you believe is right? Yeah. Alright, Ernest! I'll be back! Go right and head in there. Be careful, you two!
May the sun be with you!
Let's go! Woohoo! Okay, still seriously. Jay, please keep an eye on Jimmy for me and make sure he doesn't get too high. Jeez. Don't worry, he's a full-fledged gunslinger now.
The sun will rise tomorrow.
Oh, there you go. The fan service for you, old bowtie fans here. This is what Otenko used to say quite a lot in the old games. Pretty much an old guild gunslinger saying. You guys just make sure you don't screw up like last time, okay? If you want to continue Trinity's legacy as guild gunslingers, then you've got to get through this. I'll just leave you guys to it, okay? Yeah, well, you got your own thing to do, you know, Sartana. Yes, I'm calling you Sartana now, for some reason. Ernest, I told you he was. Yeah, he may not be the exact same Sartana we knew, but he's gradually returned to his old self. Jimmy is the key. Both sorts of that pair of something the other lacks. Is that why you let Jimmy go with him? Could be! Hong Kong Fooey! No, 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 sorry. That reminds me of that, I'm sorry. Oh, gold, well, there's three of them now, but come on, you tackled them before. Jeez, you shouldn't have two problems with this. By the way, Kay, how are your injuries? I was about to only ask you the same, Ernest. You know, Trinity might even feel like it's too long ago. Well, it's time to show these guys what a cooler man is really capable of. Oh, you don't wanna piss off a cornered guy with guns. We're certainly not. So now, we need to continue. Let me just clear some brush. Just so you can figure out why by now. Yeah, actually, let me get a few things here as well. I don't think we need a lot of circus scouts. I think I might need. Oh, actually, thinking about it, I don't think I'll need them this one because it's not really going to do as much good if one of us dies, really, because it's only going to give us a little bit of health back. Anyways, so why are we doing this? Well. Hidden items, my gosh! And the jewelry that can be sold at a shop as well! Why do you need to pick up that so much near the end of the game? Well, I'll show you why at some point. This one is especially worth something. This is a garnet of an extremely valuable jewel. This is gonna net us a fair amount. So anyway, let's go in here, because, well, this is it, folks. The central area is up ahead. We're almost at the end of this battle, aren't we? Yep, win or lose, I can't say whether either of us will live or die in here. You sure you're ready for it? Yeah, there's no losing here! I'm gonna beat Polidori! I'm coming back home alive, no matter what! This battle is to protect lives, and to stay alive! Good to hear. Let's go, Jimmy. And, yep, let's go indeed. Let's prepare for the final battle ahead, which we'll be doing in the next video, folks.